Hey everyone, I'm always up for new ways of getting to my destination. This is Reacher bringing you 10 cool vehicles shaping the future of transportation. Number 10. This what if from Toyota was designed to be a testing ground specifically for those confined to a wheelchair. Though it's named iRide, it's meant to be driven and offers an alternative to shared mobility such as buses and taxis. The driver gains entrance to the car through either of the gull wing doors. The seat slides left or right and can raise or lower to enable easier entry. The wheelchair is then lifted using a power door and stored in the back area of the car. The driver's seat is positioned in the center of the car while still allowing room for a second seat if needed. Control is maintained through the use of a joystick on the armrest, which replaces the usual pedals and steering wheel. Toyota's UEAI is incorporated into the vehicle, interacting with the driver as well as monitoring the car's functions. The fully electric car has a range of up to 93 miles on a single charge, making it great for use in urban environments where short trips are the norm. Number 9. Electrom tested their LEV prototype over 2,500 miles for 2 years in all of the conditions the real world has to offer. A 28-inch wide fiberglass and carbon fiber body sits atop an aluminum frame while incorporating mostly off-the-shelf bicycle components. The rider sits in a reclined position while pedaling with a vertical handle on each side for steering control. There's even a storage space for cargo that can be modified to carry a small passenger if needed. The generator drive acts as an automatic transmission, allowing the rider to pedal at a constant speed without having to shift gears. The energy from pedaling goes to the generator and back wheel via a chain drive. This allows for a top speed of 34 miles per hour. The pedaling and regenerative braking help supplement the battery to extend the 50-mile range. The company is currently planning a production date of mid-2018 with an estimated price of $6,000 to $8,000. Number 8. The car's official name is the Green4U Paynose Racing GTEV. That's a whole lot of words, so we'll just stick with GTEV. This concept is an all-electric race car with a performance level similar to existing long-distance race cars. Its offset cockpit allows for the battery pack to be placed on the passenger side for quick and easy swapping during a pit stop. The range is estimated at up to 110 miles with regenerative braking. An electric motor on each axle produces a total output of 600 horsepower for a top speed of 180 miles per hour. There's even talk of a street-legal version of the GTEV that seats two people in a jet fighter-style compartment. The company plans to bring their car to the 24 hours of Le Mans endurance race. Can you envision a Le Mans where a fleet of cars flies by without the roar of engines? Number 7. It goes without saying that this foldable car was inspired by the Transformers. It's called Earth One, and it may very well be the future of what a convertible will be. The idea behind it was for vehicles of the future to make better use of the limited space in metropolitan areas. Manufacturer 4Link Systems had to develop special motors and components from scratch to achieve this concept. While the car is driven via a conventional steering wheel, the chassis folds up using a joystick, allowing it to shapeshift on the go. The cockpit is accessed by lifting the front of the car like a back gate on an SUV, but the vehicle's limited space is a tight fit, even for two people. The company says that more than 30 orders have already been made at about $70,000 each. Number 6. Uber has partnered with Jump Bikes in San Francisco to offer electric bike sharing the same way you get a car ride. It's called UberBike, and it's streamlined into the existing Uber app. After signing up, the app shows you a list of all the nearby bikes. You can then choose a bike and follow the prompts to unlock it. The integrated lock has a storage spot when the bike is in use, and the basket on the front is big enough for any personal items the rider may have. Although it's not required, riders do have to use their own helmet. After the ride is completed, the user simply relocks the bike and ends the ride using the app. The ability to leave the bike anywhere adds a flexibility which could make that last bit of walking on your daily commute a thing of the past. Okay everyone, before you get caught up in planning your future commute, be sure and subscribe below. Also, don't forget to click that bell icon to stay up to date on all the latest videos. Number 5. The exterior of this concept SUV from Chinese company Byton isn't going to turn heads. It's what's on the inside that's going to make you look twice. A 49-inch interactive display stretches the length of the dashboard. Through a combination of voice commands, gestures, and facial recognition, users can set up the display orientation for maximum driving comfort. An 8-inch tablet is integrated into the center of the steering wheel, which remains in a fixed position even while the wheel is turning. This tablet also enables the driver in controlling functions of the vehicle. There are also screens on the back side of the headrest for passengers, and just like the front display, these can be used for such things as video chatting and entertainment. The base model will get you an estimated 250 miles on a single charge, while the dual motor version offers 325 miles. Number 4. Even though it looks like someone just attached 8 wheels to a box, this concept is the next generation of next generation vehicles. Toyota created the e-Palette for a range of uses including mass transit, delivery services, and even mobile businesses. The fully automated vehicle has no steering wheel, gear shift, or pedals, which also means no driver. The low floor interior is empty so it can be modified as needed by the user. The company will offer 3 different vehicle sizes ranging in length from 13 to 23 feet, allowing for a mobile solution that is not just need specific, but right sized as well. Number 3. French company Essence Motorcycles is making a statement with this limited edition e-bike. They've created a minimalist design wrapped around an eco-friendly product they call E-Raw. The part that catches your eye first is the laminated wood seat, which fills the space where the fuel tank would normally be. The curved design is made for comfort while adding ingenuity to an already distinctive feature. The electric engine produces over 100 horsepower for a maximum speed of 93 miles per hour. The 10.1 kilowatt hour battery provides a range of up to 115 miles on one charge with a recharge time of just 30 minutes. The bike weighs in at 368 pounds and can go from 0 to 62 miles per hour in just 3.5 seconds. The company plans to produce 10 units in the near future, with each one being built to order at a price of around $60,000 each. Number 2. DeLorean Aerospace has designed a 2-person VTOL aircraft called the DR-7. And if you're wondering, it's not a flying car. The composite monocoque fuselage is made to be compact, with tandem seating allowing for up to 2 passengers at a time. It measures in at 19.5 feet in length with a wingspan of 18.5 feet. It has 2 sets of wings, one in front and one in back, which fold to a width of 7.5 feet, allowing it to fit in a standard home garage. The all-electric powertrain powers a centerline twin vectoring propulsion system that produces a top speed of 240 miles per hour with a maximum range of 120 miles. A 1/3 scale model has been tested, but so far there's no information on a production date or cost for the final product. Our number one pick is next. After the video, let us know in the comments what you decided on for your future mode of travel. Number 1. It's called the Airfish 8. It has the engine of a race car, the look of a sleek seaplane, and it's classified as a merchant ship. It's designed for a crew of 2 with capacity for 6 to 8 passengers. The fuselage is 56.5 feet long with a wingspan of just over 49 feet. The power comes from a standard 500 horsepower V8 gasoline engine. This can give it a maximum speed of 122 miles per hour with a range of 345 miles. It flies at about 20 feet above the water without the need for a runway, since it takes off and lands on water. Singapore-based WidgetWorks hopes to revolutionize the way people travel and transform the high-speed maritime transport industry. This could make island exploration all the more easier, as it can reach areas where ferries and boats can't.
Hey guys, this is Cassie. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Tell us in the comments below what you found to be the most interesting and why. Also, if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit the bell notification next to the subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time.